DriverRig is a simple and necessary Blender add-on, which creates a 3D UI for controlling and animating the shape keys of any mesh or model, such as for the facial shape keys of any character. This automates the time-consuming process of setting drivers, arranging their interface, and managing all of the information, opening up a new and exciting workflow. While they are a useful tool, a necessary one even, shape keys are not easy to control. A gigantic list of shape keys controlled only by a number between 0 and 1 is hard to track and harder to animate. To combat this, many people have taken to controlling their shape keys with a bone. A single bone, after all, has the potential to control many shape keys at once. The problem is that setting all of this up, DriverRig Shape Keys to Bones is a tool that helps you create a rig for your shape keys in an easy and efficient way. The rig is generated with the click of a button and creates a 3D interface to show how everything works and fits together, making use of custom bone shapes, boundaries, and constraints to ensure every bone and every step feels intuitive. The process of setting up drivers and creating a rig is automated for you to a level of quality it would take many hours to do alone, and in a way which allows managing and handling all the systems simple. Want to change things around? It's but a click away. When you have a mesh selected, you can add a control bone by pressing the Add button. You can name the control bone and even make the names appear in the 3D interface. Below is also the list of different transformations you can use to trigger shape keys, up, down, left, right, and so on. The 3D interface will respond to which of these is active, which of these you are using, visually displaying which transforms are in use. This works on any kind of mesh, not just a human face, but throughout the video we'll be seeing it on a human face, since that's the easiest place to see examples. When you are ready, you can target an armature and generate the rig to a bone that the rig will be pounded to. Then you can press the Generate button, and the bones and 3D interface will be created, along with the drivers for the shape keys, and you can start animating. It's as simple as that. To get these custom shapes, go into the custom-bone-shapes.blend file and copy everything into the scene. You can press H to hide it. Managing and updating the rig will be much easier thanks to the visual aid of bones having shapes reflect how they can be moved. The bounds show the limit of where they can be moved to, as well as showing their default position. You can also change the location and scale of the control bone's rig and the layout of the UI here. You also have the ability to add control bones to groups. The order of items in this list reflects the order they're generated in, but items which share a group I will put together. There are also some extra features DriverRig has. In this drop-down, you can duplicate the current control bone, swap the shape keys in the left field for the right field, up for down, and so on. Or with this option here, mirror the left shape keys with the right shape keys, meaning that shape keys intended for the left half of the body are swapped for ones on the right half and vice versa. This mirroring is done dependent on the name of the shape key. It will swap around any set of shape keys which share the naming convention on screen now. The latest update allows you to add any number of shape keys to each direction, as well as allowing you to reference a single shape key multiple times. This may be used to easily create a preset, perhaps for different face expressions or phonemes, without having to create bespoke shapes for each state. This may also be useful if there are a group of shape keys which each share the same motion. This value here defines the maximum value that activating a bone will trigger in the shape key. By default, it's at 1, meaning that when the bone is fully at one of the locations, that shape key is at the value of 1. In other words, setting it to 0.5 in the jaw drop means that while the lip pull shape reaches 1, the jaw drop only reaches 0.5. If you go into the shape key itself and increase the max value, you allow that shape key to be triggered by multiple bones. By default, if a shape key has already been fully activated by one bone, it's reached 1, moving another bone won't change it. By increasing the max value, you allow this to happen. These tools allow you to quickly make a full setup for your rig. Iterating designs is lightning fast, since any change you make can be easily implemented, and the process of animating all these shape keys becomes much easier. Setting up rigging and drivers is a notoriously time-consuming process. Its complexity discourages creativity and experimentation, since any change just takes so long to try out. With DriverRig in hand, the probabilities and possibilities unfurl before you. So let this script, so fine and neat, be thy guide in shape-key feet. No longer toil, nor sweat, nor moan, but make thy models truly flown.